for me as an immigrant, because I grew up, you know, when I came over here, me, my family, my sister, four people, we live in like one bedroom apartment for 10 years. And you know, when I go to college, we have six people in two bedroom apartment. You know, and you know, when I get out of college, I was able to rent a basement for $500. And then I'm lucky myself, I got a graduate college degree. And you know, I can't even afford a, you know, affordable house here in Auckland. And you know, what am I supposed to do? What I did not realize when before I joined GMB is that all the decision making on building, you know, how, who build what, where, it's all happening in the city hall. One of the, you know, thing I remember is that I go up to Santana City Hall and then speak about a project, and you know, the person going for me was like, they see, you know, they got all the booths, and then when I come up, you know, there was just a silent room, you know, listen to me talking. I thought that was fun, you know, like, okay. But that, it just showed me that as a minority, when I came up there, I thought like, I'm a minority, you know, who will listen to me? You know, that, you know, that's my perspective coming up. But I was surprised when I came up as a minority, you know, when I was standing there talking in front of the city hall people and the NIMBY behind me, you know, I feel that, you know, there's a, you know, that I feel like that, yeah, my voice have power. If you care about money, you care about, you know, where you live, if you care about building wealth, and you should care about Zimbi. In order to have that kind of fight, you have to go over there and speak up, you know, and so the developer can hear you and the city council can hear you. You know, so if you want all that new thing happening in your city, you need to show it up in the city, you know, and start talking. Otherwise, nobody hear you, nobody listen. So that's why you need to get out of there.